Alors, is everyone ready? دكتور إسراء، وهي في بعض النسخ صوت بني إسرائيل. نعم، ولا حرج في ذلك. فالسورة قد تكون لها أو يكون لها اسمان. Today we'll start صوت الإسراء. نعم. I hope everybody is on the page already. سورة الإسراء. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. صلوات الله وسلامهم عليهم. هذه الآية، هذه السورة is called سورة الإسراء. قيل مكية. It means usually when they say مكية it's most of the surahs. Maybe you could find some of the verses are Madaniya, right? Or do you find the majority is what? Is Makkiyah. That's why they said here you have some of the verses that are Madaniya. كَقَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى وَإِنْ كَادُوا لَيَسْتَفِزُّونَكَ. Okay? And وَقُلْ رَبِّ أَدْخِلْنِي مُدْخَلَ صِدْقٍ وَأَخْرِجْنِي مُخْرَجَ صِدْقٍ. وقوله إن ربك أحاط بالناس. So you have some مدنية. And we said before the difference between مكية and مدنية. المكية ما نزلت قبل الحجرة. والمدنية ما نزلت بعد الحجرة. ولا علاقة لها بالجغرافيا. It's not. فالآية قد تكون مدنية وقد نزلت بمكة. Okay? The ayah could be Madaniya, but although it was revealed in Mecca after Al-Hijra, just like when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Al-Yawma akmaltu lakum deenakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati wa raditu lakum al-Islama. And this ayah is one of the last ayah that were revealed to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's not the last one. Okay? A lot of scholars said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the last ayah is, وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا تُرْجَعُونَ فِيهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ. في سورة الايه؟ سورة البقرة. وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا تُرْجَعُونَ فِيهِ. The mistake that we make with, because this ayah, the meaning will make you feel that it's the last ayah. الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ. But it was revealed in حَجَّةِ الْوَدَاعِ. Yes, but after that, many some of the ayats were revealed after him. قالوا واتقوا يوما ترجعون فيه إلى الله ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت وهم لا يظلمون. So we know what مكية and مدنية means. Then we come to the surah. قال سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده. سبحان بمعنى تنزه عن كل شيء. سبحان in Arabic it means تنزه الله عن كل عيب. Anything that has been attributed to Allah, which He does not deserve, Allah is totally away from it. Just like you say, وَقَالُوا اتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ وَلَدًا سُبْحَانَ. Anytime this word comes, you have a feeling that the word that came before that, Allah doesn't deserve that. لَأَنَّ مِنْ تَعْذِيمِ حَقِّ اللَّهِ أن تثبت بعض الصفات وتنفي بعض الصفات. هناك صفات إثبات وصفات نفي. That's very important. لا تثبت لله كل شيء. ما اتخذ الله من ولد وما كان معه من إذن لذهب كل إله بما ولا على بعضهم. Not everything that you attribute to Allah. No, sometimes we do not have to attribute something to Allah. And this is within glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why he said, سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده. الإسراء in Arabic is to travel at night. أسرى. الإسراء. أسرى بعبده. And Abdu here is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said that because tashrifan lahu. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to glorify you, he will attribute you to him. Bi abdi, his servant. Okay? وَإِنَّهُ لَمَّا قَامَ عَبْدُ اللَّهِ يَدْعُوهُ كَادُوا يَكُونُونَ عَلَيْهِ لِبَدًا الحمد لله الذي نزل الفرقان على عبده. You have a lot of ayat like that. ما شاء الله. And I give you an example here. When you come home and you find a very, very good food, and you say, ما شاء الله. Ah, this food is good. But you have people who are serving you. But your wife said, no, I made this by myself. You will be even more happier than what? Than food itself, right? I made it by myself. I didn't make anybody make it. You see, subhanAllah. And this is tashrifan. قال من المسجد الحرام. From Mecca. Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم left Mecca at night. Okay? إلى المسجد الأقصى. To Jerusalem. Yeah. الذي باركنا حوله الذي باركنا حوله. And as a matter of fact, this is talking about al-Isra. We have two things here: al-Isra wal-Mi'raj. Al-Isra is to travel at night, okay? Wal-Mi'raj is to go. Aha, يعلم ما يلج في الأرض وما يعرش. يعرش is going up. So we have two things. But here, he talk about the first one, Al-Isra. And if you go to Surah Al-Najm, he will talk about Al-Mi'raj. قال إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله. There's a lot of baraka surrounding what? What baraka is here? قالوا من الثمار وبمجاري الأنحار وقيل بمن دفن حوله من الأنبياء. من الأنبياء. This place is blessed. We all know that. It's one of the most important places on earth. باركنا حوله is a lot of baraka also surrounding it. A lot of the prophets are buried in that particular place. And you have rizq also there. فَالْبُقْعَةُ مُبَارَكَةٌ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. The place is blessed. Not only that, but the only three places where you're supposed to travel to see are these three what? Places. المسجد الحرام, المسجد النبوي, والمسجد الأقصى. And it was called Al-Aqsa because it's far from Mecca. Al-Qasi wa Dani. In Arabic, Qasiyan, it means Ba'idan, Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. And the Arab, they had a culture of traveling to this place. If they had to go with the camel, it took them a month. That's how far it is. This is why it was a miracle that Prophet goes there in what? And as a matter of fact, Buraq took him from Mecca to Al-Aqsa. From there they went up. This creature, Allah created it as a means of transportation only for the angels, for the prophets. It's not only Prophet Muhammad who uses this. No. It probably has been used by other prophets. مخلوق من مخلوقات الله لا يستعمل إلا من قبل الأنبياء. Okay, this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's an animal between البغل والحمار. It's a different way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this. This is the one that took him there. Okay. قال why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did that? لنريه من آياتنا. All of this are miracles. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed him his what? is miracle. That we told you one night, you leave Makkah and you go to Jerusalem, mu'jiza. And from there you find all the prophets, you did the salat, mu'jiza. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took those prophets, brought them to everyone to his own location in the sky. Because they don't live in a same place. Sama'ud dunya, you have Adam. Sama'ud thani, you have another one. I think Zakaria and what? Yahya. Thalitha, you have. Rabi'a, Khamisa, Sadisa. And Musa is in the sixth. Sayyidina Ibrahim is on the seventh. Then after that, you go up. Every single place, you may have one prophet or the other. Okay? All of this are miracle of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh, na'am. نعم جاء بهم لأنهم أحياء عند ربهم يرزقون والله على كل شيء قدير. Not only that before Prophet Muhammad get there, he brought them back to what? تذكر دائما أن الله على كل شيء قدير ومقاييسنا تختلف عن مقاييس الله سبحانه وتعالى. الله سبحانه وتعالى, I mean, here we're talking about the speed of time. But the speed of time for him is just enormous. It could be millions of miles in a second. Now, remember the story of Sayyidina Sulaiman and what? قال من يأتيني بعرشها قبل أن يأتوني مسلمين. قال عفريت من الجن أنا آتيك به قبل أن تقوم وإني عليه لا قوي أمين. But فاستبطأ ذلك. يعني that was very slow for him. Look at سيدنا سليمان. سبحان الله. He said, by the time you leave your seat here, it's here. I said, no, that's too slow. The other one said, أنا آتيك به قبل أن يرتد إليك طرفك. Now, what is the speed of time here? Huh? What is the speed of time here? A what? A million, 10,000 miles in a second? It's just unbelievable. But look, we the human, we try to invent stuff that are quicker than what? Now we have we have what's called TGV in Europe, right? This highest speed train, and they are not, even in Maghreb now they have they call it, you know what's funny in Maghreb, they call it Al Buraq. They call this high speed train Al Buraq. يعني امتثالا بي What I want to say is that how quick it is. هذه من آيات الله وكان أيضا ابتلاء لمن قوي إيمانه أو ضعف إيمانه because some people ارتدوا من أجل هذا some people became كفار because of this Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم when he told them that he when Isra happened they said no this is unbelievable this guy is too much yes and they even came to Abu Bakr Siddiq did you hear what your man is saying he said what is he saying They said yesterday أسرى به إلى عرج به إلى السماء. ولكن كان قوي الإيمان. But his iman was what? Was stronger. سيدنا أبو بكر الصديق was very strong. قال يأتيه الخبر من السماء فأصدقه. إذا قال لي عرج به فأصدقه. He said the message come to him from where? From the sky and I believe that. If he tell me today that he has been there, I'm going to for Summi Abu Bakr as Siddiq. Okay. Now let's go back. قال إنه So Isra happened from Mecca to Al Medina. Now the question is from Mecca to Al Aqsa, from Al Aqsa to As Sama. Now the question is, why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did that? It's to create the connection between Masjid al-Haram and what? Masjid al-Aqsa. We the Muslim, we have to understand this connection. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could have easily taken Prophet from Mecca to Sama. Salam. لماذا يأتي به إلى مسجد الأقصى؟ Why does he bring him to Masjid al-Aqsa? To tell you that there is a connection here. There is a connection here. And this is why he told Ibrahim, go and put some of your seed in Mecca and go and bring the rest of what? The connection here. We have to understand those connections. Okay? Now, after that, now, what does he say after that? وَآتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابَ يعني كرمنا محمدا بالمعراج إنه كان سميعا إنه هو السميع البصير السميع البصير we talk about that here a lot right إنه يسمع ما نقول أها وهو يرى ما نعمل السمع لما تقول والبصر لما تعمل. He sees what we do and he hears what we say. Okay. قال وآتينا موسى الكتاب. سبحان الله. Allah سبحانه وتعالى brings سيدنا موسى right away. وجعلناه I gave him the Torah. The kitab here is what? Huh? The kitab here is the Torah. وجعلناه هدى لبني إسرائيل and it was really a guidance for Bani Israel and now he warned them أن لا تتخذوا من دوني وكيلا يعني لا تتخذوا شريكا لا تتخذوا وكيلا تتوكلوا على الله the scholars مجاهد قال هنا ولا تتخذوا وكيلا يعني لا تتخذوا شريكا and this what السياق يدل على ذلك even the way the context will show you that the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told them do not associate anything to me okay ذرية من حملنا مع نوح he's calling the family that were taken with Sayyidina Nuh عليه الصلاة والسلام وكأنه نداء وحرف النداء مهذوف يعني يا ذرية وتقديره يا ذرية من حملنا Oh you the lineage of Sayyidina Nuh that I brought because all of us we are what? We are in those lineage you know because from there We know, we all know that, you know, after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spread the world. Then of his children, some of them became this race and that race and that race. وَلِذَٰلِكَ رَجَعَ إِلَىٰ نُوحٍ هُنْ ذُرِّيَّةَ مَعَ مَنْ حَمَلْنَا أَهَا أَهَا وَذَكَرَ نُوحًا لِيُذَكِّرَهُمْ نِعْمَةَ الْإِنْجَاءِ مِنَ الْغَرْقِ عَلَىٰ أَبَائِهِ He's reminding us that Allah saved us from drowning at that particular time to save the humanity. That's why he said, "Aha, فَحْمِلْ كُلَّهَا مِنْ كُلِّ زَوْجَيْنِ اثنين وَأَحْلَكْ إِلَّا مَنْ سَبَقَ عَلَيْهِ الْقَوْلُ وَمَنْ آمَنَ ذُرِّيَّةَ مَنْ حَمَلْنَا مَعَ نُوحٍ بِمَعْنَى يَا ذُرِّيَّةَ مَنْ حَمَلْنَا مَعَنَا I'm talking to you, the family of Sayyidina Nuh. وبعد ذلك قال إنه كان عبدا شكورا. Sayyidina Nuh, one of the attributes of Sayyidina Nuh, كان يشكر الله على نعمه. إذا بدأ يأكل يقول بسم الله. وإذا انتهى من الأكل يقول الحمد لله. وإذا دخل الخلاء يقول اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الخبث والخبائث وإذا خرج يقول الحمد لله الذي أمسك عني ما ينفعني which mean every single step of سيدنا نوح he thank Allah سبحانه وتعالى we have to thank Allah even being able to eat and keep the vitamin in your body and release what you don't need is ni'mah. Of course, we know when you're constipated, it's a big problem, right? When you're constipated, it's what? It's a big problem. When you have digestive problem, is what? It's a big problem. Even this is ni'mah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that Sayyidina Nuh kana abdan shakuran. He used to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, he went back to the main issue here. قَالَ وَقَضَيْنَا إِلَىٰ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ. The word qada has a lot of meaning. It doesn't have one meaning. Okay? Qada means it could be his I made him die. فَلَمَّا قَضَيْنَا عَلَيْهِ فَلَمَّا قَضَيْنَا عَلَيْهِ الْمَوْتَ مَا دَلَّهُمْ عَلَىٰ إِلَّا دَابَّةُ الْأَرْضِ. قَضَيْتَ means it could be finished. فَإِذَا قَضَيْتُمُ الصَّلَاةَ فَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا. وَقَضَيْنَا it could be إعلام. Let you know. This is what we have here. وَقَضَيْنَا it could be الْأَمْرُ. أَمْرُ مِنَ اللَّهِ. وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ. So كلمة قضى, the word قضى has a lot of meaning. But trust me, you will know exactly what it means anyway. You understand? هذا قال وقضينا إلى بني إسرائيل يعني أعلمناه. I let them know في الكتاب يعني في اللوح المحفوظ. Okay? He told them قال لتفسدن في الأرض مرتين. Your mischief on this earth is going to be twice. Okay? وَلَتَعَلُنَّ عُلُوًّا كَبِيرًا. And you are going to be very arrogant. Okay? But, so, الْجَزَاءُ دَائِمًا مِنْ جِنْسِ الْعَمَلِ. Whenever you do something, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will pay you according to what? وَجَزَاءُ سَيِّئَةٍ سَيِّئَةٌ مِثْلُهَا. هَلْ جَزَاءُ الْإِحْسَانِ إِلَّا الْإِحْسَانِ. قَالَ فَإِذَا جَاءَ وَعَدُ أُولَاهُمَا. Whenever the time of one of them comes, بمعنى الفساد, whenever you do that, any kind of mischief that you are going to do, after that, what is going to happen? بَعَثْنَا عَلَيْكُمْ عِبَادًا لَنَا. I will, يعني صَلَّتْنَا عَلَيْكُمْ. I will send some of my servant. Now, عِبَادًا here, he didn't say عِبَادَنَا. عبادنا هذا تشريف ولكن قال عبادا لنا أي عبد. They don't even have to be Muslim. It's in the beginning he said سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده. If he wanted to say these people are good people, he could have said بعثنا عليكم عبادنا. But he didn't say that. قال عبادا لنا. Any of my servants. أولي بأس شديد. These people are very strong. فجاسوا خلال الديار. They will go through your neighborhood looking for destruction and everything. جاسوا خلال الديار. وكان وعدا مفعولا. This is going to be done. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let them know. And this one has happened already. In history, there was a time when they disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah sallata alayhi. It could be Bukhtunsur, it could be any king of Babel. Yeah. Historically, when you go back to the book of history, they know that and it happened to them. Go to the story of Bani Israel. That was a time when they were attacked, their kingdom was destroyed by kings. Just according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is going to happen after that? That they will repent again. They will go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They will repent again. And they will go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is what is going to happen, because when people when they learn hardship, they will sit down and say, what's wrong? That's like what is happening to us today. We all know that is happening. وَمَا أَصَابَكُمْ مِنْ مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ وَيَعْفُ عَنْ. What has happened to the Islamic world is simply because of our own mistake. So, but people will sit down and say, SubhanAllah, what did we do wrong? This is what happened to Bani Israel. When they disobeyed Allah, Allah sent them people. And those people, فَجَاسُوا خِلَالَ الدِّيَارِ وَكَانَ وَعَدًا. It was, aha, قَالُوا, now, this is going back to history. But what we know is that when they disobeyed Allah in the beginning, He sent them people who persecuted them. And He said that, وَكَانَ وَعَدًا مَفْعُولًا. It's going to happen. Ah. Now what happened after that? قَالَ ثُمَّ رَدَدْنَا لَكُمُ الْكَرَّةَ عَلَيْهِمْ عَنِ الدَّوْلَةَ وَالرَّجْعَةَ. They will get stronger again. And this particular time could be in a time of history where their kingdom will be what? Stronger again. Wallahu a'lam, maybe this one has happened again. Because remember, the scholars said the best time of Bani Israel was when? In the time of who? Huh? No, Sayyidina Dawood and Sayyidina his son, Sulaiman. That was the best time of Bani Israel. That was the kingdom of Bani Israel. I will tell you. That's very recent. Okay, that's very recent. Because Sayyidina Musa came after Sayyidina Dawood came after Sayyidina Musa. People think that Dawood is all alone. The whole story of Sayyidina Musa, Sayyidina Sulaiman is after سيدنا موسى. قال تعالى سورة البقرة. أها. قال ماذا قال سورة البقرة؟ قال فقتل داود جالوت فأتيناه الله فأتاه الله الملك والحكمة. ولكن the beginning of it is when الله سبحانه وتعالى said قال إذ قالوا لنبي الله إن الله ابعث لنا ملكا نقاتل في سبيل الله. In that army, سيدنا داود was there. And he's the one who killed Jalut. Allah gave him the kingdom. And after that, this was the best army of Bani Israel. Those people had Iman, they were Muslimin. قالوا كم من فئة قليلة غلبت فئة. We do not have to be affected by what is happening now. There was a time when these people were very, very good, to be honest with you. Yeah. وَلِذَٰلِكَ, this is why among those who will get into paradise massively were what? The followers of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wa salam. So what we are trying to say here, that particular time, that was the time, the best time of Bani Israel. قَالَ ثُمَّ رَدَدْنَا لَكُمُ الْكَرَّةَ عَلَيْهِمْ وَأَمْدَدْنَاكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ. سبحان الله. وَكَأَنَّ هَذَا قَضَاءٌ كَوْنِي. Allah is telling you everything that is going to happen. Because قَالَ وَكَانَ وَعْدًا مَفْعُولًا. وَهَذَا الْقَضَاءُ بِالنِّسْبَةِ لِكَوْنِي يعني ليس شرعياً. It will happen, it's going to happen. And all this happened in history. قَالَ وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ أَكْثَرَ نَفِيرًا. نَفِير means الأموال والأولاد والقوة. There will be a time when you become stronger and stronger. Okay? سبحان الله. قَالَ إِنْ أَحْسَنْتُمْ أَحْسَنْتُمْ لِي. If you are kind, that will be for you. وَإِنْ أَسَأْتُمْ فَلَحَ. If you are what? قَالَ فَإِذَا جَاءَ وَعَدُ الْآخِرَةِ لِيَسُوءُوا وُجُوحَكُمْ وَلْيَدْخُلُوا الْمَسْجِدَ كَمَا دَخَلُوهُ أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ وَلْيُتَبِّرُوا مَا عَلَوْا. Here, that's where the issue is. When the time of Al-Akhirah comes, there will be another power that is going to come. And this issue it could be related to the time that we are living now. وليدخلوا المسجد كما دخلوه أول مرة. وليتبروا ما علوا تتبيرا. الإشكال هنا, the problem here, is this talking to Bani Israel? Or is talking to the Muslims? Now let's listen to very. قال فإذا جاء وعد الآخرة وذلك أنهم قتلوا يعني الفساد that happened to them is a lot, especially the killing of who? سيدنا يحيى بن زكريا. Yes, that was one of the biggest problems they had. وقتل الأنبياء is not taken lightly by Allah سبحانه وتعالى. قال ليسوءوا وجوهكم وليدخلوا المسجد كما دخلوه أول مرة وليتبروا ما علوا تتبيرا. هذا هو الاختلاف بين المفسرين. Who is being mentioned here? This could be a Muslim. ليسوء وجوهكم وليدخلوا المسجد كما دخلوه أول مرة. The same way they got into the masjid for the first time, which means, you know, Masjid al-Aqsa, it has always the story of being occupied and liberated. Occupied and what? Liberated. You see? وَلْذَلِكَ قَالَ وَلْيَدْخُلُوا الْمَسْجِدَ كَمَا دَخَلُوهُ أَوَّلَ مَرَّةً وَلْيُتَبِّرُوا مَا عَلَوْا تَتْبِيرًا. قَالَ عَسَى رَبُّكُمْ أَنْ يَرْحَمَكُمْ. Some scholars said that this is coming to us now. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can have a mercy upon you. If you go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have mercy. So this is the most important part of Suratul Isra. Because it's talked to Bani Israel. And it talks to us too. قَالَ عَسَى رَبُّكُمْ أَنْ يَرْحَمَكُمْ. وَإِنْ عُدْتُمْ عدنا وجعلنا جهنم للكافرين عسيرا. وإن عدتم, if you go back to what you do, يعني من الفساد, the mischief that you do, Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, I will come back to you. إذن يعني وكأن الأمر, like the issue is not only about Bani Israel. Sometimes he talks to them, sometimes he comes back to us. Some scholars even said that some of the ayat here are going back to us as a Muslim. وَإِنْ عُدْتُمْ عُنَّا وَجَعَلْنَا جَحَنَّمَ الْكَافِرِينَ حَصِيرًا. What is important here, and wallahi, I did not find any ayah that the scholars have been talking about more than what? This ayah. Oh yes. With a different meaning of it. What we know is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let them know how they have to behave if they do something wrong. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come back. Okay? And they know that in the history that we are living in. This is why he said, in ahsantum ahsantum wa in asatum falaha. فَإِذَا جَاءَ وَعْدُ الْآخِرَةِ لِيَسُوءُوا وُجُوهَكُمْ وَلْيَدْخُلُوا الْمَسْجِدَ كَمَا دَخَلُوهُ أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ. وَعْدُ الْآخِرَةِ يعني من إفسادكم. Some of them say وعد الآخرة is the last one of the mischief that you will do. As I will tell you, هذا من قتل يحيى بن زكريا عليه الصلاة والسلام. That was the camel that the straw that broke the camel's back. قال فإذا جاء وعد الآخرة ليسوء وجوهكم يعني بالتعذيب وليدخلوا المسجد كما دخلوه أول مرة وليتبروا ما علوا تتبيرا. So this is somehow, some scholars say some of these verses are going back to them and some of them are going back to us. Okay? Very, very important. But what is important here is that we have a lot of prophecies of the mischief that they are going to commit in the last time. Okay. قال عسى ربكم أن يرحمكم. سبحان الله. He said, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may have mercy upon you, wa in udtum udna, subhanAllah. But if you go back to what you do, I will come back. This surah has to, if somebody has to learn from Suratul Isra, it has to be Bani Israel. Okay? This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, according to some riwayah, is called Surah Bani Israel. قال إن أحسنتم أحسنتم لأنفسكم وإن أسأتم إيه فلاحا. If you are kind, you are kind to yourself. If not, then that is upon you. قال وإن عدتم إيه عدنا. هذا وعد بالفعل ورد الفعل. Okay, it is a promise of an action and a reaction by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what I think about this ayat, according to my little knowledge, is that هذه القضاء, القضاء هنا قضاء, قضاء كوني. The thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said here, if you do it, I'm going to do it. If you can, it will be kind. If not, then you have to know that I'm going to, how I'm going to react, inshallah. قال وجعلنا جهنم للكافرين حصيرا. الحصير وكأنه سجن يعني محبسا وسجنا. أي made جهنم والكفار what حصيرا يعني سجنا ومحبسا. جهنم is a place where it's like a prison, and we all know what prison means, right? You don't get out of what? Prison. كلما أرادوا أن يخرجوا منها أعيدوا فيها. قال وجعلنا جهنم للكافرين أها حسيرا. It's a matter of fact. The last ayah that we talk about, subhanAllah, the meaning is a lot. There is an issue of language there, the issue of history, and the history of a lot of lugha, okay? Inshallah. Hala, we did the best to make it clear to you, inshallah. After that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He told them this, and as a matter of fact, if you go to history, you'll find how many times these things happen, okay? From that time He told them until the recent time, okay? Very, very important. Hala, inna hadha al-Qur'ana, aha, yahdi lillati, aha, hiya aqwam. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes back to Al-Qur'an al-Kareem, قَالَ إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَى. Qur'an will lead you to what is right and just. Okay? يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَى. Which means that everything that is good, Al-Quran has what? Has guided you towards. Okay? وَيُبَشِّرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الَّذِينَ أَهَا يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ أَنَّ لَهُمْ أَهَا أَنَّ لَهُمْ أَجْرًا كَبِيرًا. What is the أجر الكبير? Well, Jannah. Quran not only guided you to what? This is why the scholar said, everything that comes to Al-Quran al-Kareem will lead you the best way. It lead you to the best way of your life. It lead you to the best way of your salat. It lead you to the best way of your zakat. Lead you to the best way of your marriage and the education. يهدي للتي هي أقوم. وجاء على أيه على وزن الأيه على وزن التفضيل الذي أقوم. قال وَيُبَشِّرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And also it comes as what? As a glad what? Tiding. أَنَّ لَهُمْ أَجْرًا كَبِيرًا بمعنى لَهُمُ الْجَنَّةِ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised them what? الْجَنَّةِ. وَأَنَّ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ. Those who do not believe in the day of judgment, أَعْتَدْلَا لَهُمْ عَذَابًا أَلِيمًا. A severe punishment is being prepared for them. والعياذ بالله. After that he comes, قال ويدعو الإنسان بالشر دعاءه بالخير. الدعاء بالشر, how that is happening? الدعاء, we know دعاء بالخير, right? ولكن كيف الدعاء بالشر? الدعاء بالشر is to is to قال عند الغضب صحيح تدعو بما لا تريد ان يحصل لك قال دعاء الرجل على نفسه وولده عند الدجر بما لا يحب ان يستجاب له تقول له الله may make you this may make you that but in your heart you because when we get angry we talk what and we are very quick in doing this just like we make dua of al-khair we are quick in everything may Allah make you this may Allah make you that you are angry with your son but in your heart what you know in our language in our language when you get mad against your son you say I'm going to kill you you see farabi you see so one of our brother in Canada he said that to his daughter the daughter went to school he said my father want to they took it seriously because they don't know but in reality it's not what is in your heart شوف قال ويدعو الانسان بالشر دعاءه بالخير يعني he is very quick to say something that he doesn't have in heart not something bad and that's not good and it's also like saying وقالوا اللهم ربنا ان كان هذا هو الحق من عندك فامطر علينا نجاره من السماء Subhanallah, he's saying, Allah, if this is true, destroy us. No, you say, if it's true, guide us. But if it's true, and it turned true, you ask Allah to, ولذلك قال سيدنا صالح أعتقد قال يا قوم لما تستعجلون بالسيئة قبل لولا تستغفرون الله لولا سيدنا صالح نعم قال يا قوم لم تستعجلون بالسيئة قبل الحسنة لولا تستعجلون لها لعلكم سبحان الله نعم this one he's talking here ولذلك this one at the end قال وكان الإنسان عجولا وكان الإنسان عجولا we want everything يعني طبيعة الإنسان العجلة we in our nature we want something to, everything to be what quick a human being want everything to be quick he come to the masjid he wants salah to be finish and go where he want to go he want to get there quick he want to eat he want to finish what everything وكان يعني طبيعته العجلة ابن سبحان الله قال after that وجعلنا الليل والنهار آيتين يعني علامتين على وحدانيتنا ووجودنا one of the miracle of Allah if the days are days and nights I mean imagine how days come and night what comes And the sign of days is what? It the sun. The sign of the night is the moon. Yes. This is why he said, فَمَحَوْنَا آيَةَ اللَّيْلِ آيَةَ اللَّيْلِ, the sign, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala covers it. We don't see a lot of things at night time. He said, even this, the moon that we have, Allah took nur out of it. He took the light out of it. And made it so little. So it would not be as strong as what? At the sun. That's what he said. فَمَحَوْنَا آيَةَ اللَّيْلِ وَجَعَلْنَا آيَةَ النَّحَارِ مُبْصِرًا The daytime you see everything. لِتَبْتَغُوا فَضْلًا مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ That's how we find rizq. If there's no days and night, life is not going to be stable. Okay, there has to be a time we will know that it's night, it's a sleeping time. Okay? And within that time, we will know what is 24 hours. وَذَلِكَ يَسِيرُ وَلِتَعْلَمُوا عَدَدَ السِّنِينَ وَالْحِسَابِ. If there was no day and night, we wouldn't know 24 hours. We wouldn't know 7 days. We wouldn't know a week or what? A month, a year. So these two things is very pivotal, very important in our life. Ah, you see, there's a miracle of it, but also تَبْتَغُوا فَضْلًا أَيْ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ. أها ولأيه أها يعني التصرف في المعاش. You know, because you know, night time now, everybody's tired, right? We go and what? And get some rest, to get ready for what? For tomorrow. هذا في معاشنا. تبتغوا فضلا بي. We look for a provision. But not only that, but it helps us. Because we will know that one day has passed, 2 days has passed, 3 days has what? A week has passed, a month is already here, and a year is already here. وَلِتَعَلَمُوا عَدَدَ السِّنِينَ وَالْحِسَابِ. And every calculation is based on the days and what? And nights. Yeah. قَالَ وَكُلَّ شَيْءٍ فَصَّلْنَاهُ تَفْصِيلًا. From there you will know that everything has been detailed. Okay? And subhanAllah. After that, قال وكل إنسان ألزمناه طائره في عنقه. It's like something put on your neck, which is your rizq and ajal and everything. طائره في عنقه يعني معاشه ومعاده ورزقه. ألزمناه طائره. قال طائره ما قدر عليه من خير و وشر وهو ملازمه أين كان. You see, what has been preordained on you is like it is on your neck here. There is no لا مفر منه. وهذه عبارة. There is no way that you can escape. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, everything that has been preordained is like it is put on your neck. Okay? That's why he said, ونخرج له يوم القيامة كتابا كتابا يلقاه يلقاه منشورا. اقرا كتابك. Now what has been what you have been doing in your life, everything is what is what is recorded. That is your kitab. Now اقرا كتابك. كفى بنفسك اليوم عليك. Subhanallah. Today you will know. Now if I give you my if you give me my record, I know this is what I did that, right? And it's like I'm a witness of myself. كفى بنفسك عليك. This is why at the next ayah, قال من اهتدى فإنما يهتدي لنفسه. Whoever is guided for himself. وَمَنْ ضَلَّ فَإِنَّمَا يَضِلُّ عَلَيْهَا. If you go astray, that is upon you. قَالَ وَلَا تَزِرُ وَازِرَةٌ وِزْرَ أُخْرَى. Remember, nobody takes the burden of what? Of the other. Of course, this is a big issue. Some of the kuffar, they said, قَالَ اتَّبِعُوا سَبِيلَنَا وَلِنَحْمِلْ خَطَايَاكُمْ وما هم بحاملين من خطاياهم من شيء. Nobody will come and tell you, do this and I will assume it myself. No. ولا تزر وازرة وزر أخرى. لا تزر وازرة وزر أخرى. This is why he said, وما كنا معذبين حتى نبعث رسولا. I will never punish. I will never hold you responsible as if I don't send you what? A messenger. Okay? And Al-Hafidh here, he will come. This word is very important. That you cannot make a mistake and I pay for it. But at the same time, those who did not receive a message, they are not going to be punished. Right? يسمونهم بأصحاب الفترة in Arabic. They are the people of between two prophets. They didn't get this one and the other one came. By the time they came, the other one is gone. And they didn't get the other one who is following him. وهذا في حكم الله. You see, there's a lot of hadith that Al-Hafidh explained here, which we have to delve into a little bit. Just like say the إن الميت لا يعذب ببكاء أهله. You know that hadith. إن الميت لا يعذب ببكاء أهله. That hadith is true. But what it means really? If someone dies, and of course, shedding tears is okay. But some kind of cry, we know what is what? It's haram. What you call a niyaha? Jumping up and down and tearing your clothes and saying da'wal a al jahiliya. This is a the deceased person who passed away will not like what you are doing. You understand? He will not appreciate the way you are behaving after him. It doesn't mean that he will be punished for what you are doing. No. No. Because as we know, when someone dies, the thing we do surrounding him, he feels them, right? Huh? We know that. He feels them. He knows everything. Even if you are washing him, whatever you are saying, he hears. That's why those who died in Ghazwat Badr, Prophet Kim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was Abu Jahl, هل وجدتم ما وعد ربكم حقا? Umar said, إنهم جيفة. قال لا, والله لا أنت بأسمع منه. He said, قال كيف تكلم جيفة? Umar told him, how can you speak to these deceased dead people? He said, no, Umar, they hear you. You don't hear them better than A. You don't hear this better than them. They know exactly, but they cannot. Okay. They just cannot respond. The same thing. If we believe, if we have the ayah, if we believe in this ayah, then somebody's mistake is not going to be somebody's punishment. No. وَلَا تَدْرُ وَذِرَةٌ وِذْرَةٌ. And this is why I said, وَمَا كُنَّا مُعَذِّبِينَ حَتَّى نَبْعَثَ رَسُولًا. Of course, they have a lot of hadith that is talking about that they will be questioned, they will be called, prophets will be sent to them, they will ask, what we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not wrong anyone. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَظْلِمُ النَّاسَ شَيْئًا. Okay? Let's leave it that like that. هم في حكم الله. Allah knows what to do with them. Those who never received any message. Okay? Very, very important. قال وإذا أردنا أن نهلك قرية أمرنا مترفيها. سبحان الله. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if Allah Ta'ala want to destroy any town, أمر مترفيها. مترفين, the most luxured people. They are the wealthiest, the people of power. And most of the time, they are the ones who refuse prophets. Okay? The poor are always who are most likely to accept. المترفون, they don't want to leave their own comfort. Okay, they refuse. قال وكذلك ما أرسلنا في قرية من نذير إلا قال مترفوها إنا وجدنا آباءنا على yes. الزخرف قال إنا وجدنا آباءنا على أمة right وإنا على آثارهم مقتدون. You see, مترفوها, they every single facade the mischief that you see is coming from the lectured people and the people of power. If you take the share of Hollywood out of what we have, what is going to be left? Huh? The entertainers, right? Everything but mischief we see. Yes. They're the one who promote this and that, and millions of people are behind them. Ah, خَالَفَ فَسَقُوا فِيهَا يَعْنِي عَصَوَ اللَّهَ فِيهَا. Whenever you see that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, these are the people who will be spearheading every mischief. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قَالَ ذَلِكَ فَحَقَّ عَلَيْهَا الْقَوْلِ. Whenever that mischief is rampant, now that's the reason for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to destroy them. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ فَدَمَّرْنَاهَا أَهَا تَدْمِيرًا. Then they will be destroyed. Okay, this is what happened all the time in history. But one of the ni'mah about this ummah is that it is not going to be destroyed totally. We will have some problems here and there. And when I say ummah, I'm not talking about ummah till Islam only. It will be about the whole universe. It will never be destroyed again, just like it was before. No. قَالَ تَعَالَى وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَأَنْتَ فِيهِمْ وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. You see, as long as you have people who are making istighfar, Allah will save us. But sometimes there's a little beating, okay? And I think this is mostly the sunnah of those who came before us, okay? For us, you will have problem here and there, but it's not a total what? Destruction. وَهَذِهِ مِنْ نَعْمِ اللَّهِ عَلَيْنَا. Okay, قال فحق عليها القول فدمرناها تدميرا. قال وكم أهلكنا من قبلهم من القرون من بعد نوح. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying there are so many nations after Sayyidina Nuh that were destroyed. From that time, the destruction. Started with Sayyidina Nuh, his people. And it went up to Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wa salam. That's a generation after generation. And it said, we remember we passed this few days ago, قَالَ أَنْتُمْ مُوفُونَ سَبْعِينَ أُمَّةً. It's like we had 70 generations. That's a lot. Because given the fact, one generation could take 1,000 of what? 1,000 of years. قَالَ أَنْتُمْ مُوفُونَ. Because this question comes a lot. How many generations has been between us from the time of Sayyidina Nuh to the time of Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. قَالَ أَنْتُمْ مُوفُونَ سَبْعِينَ أُمَّةً أَنْتُمْ أَفْضَلُهَا. Yeah. Those ummah that pass is more than is 70. But we are the best. We are the best. Okay? This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here is reminding us, قَالَ وَكَمْ أَحْلَكْنَا مِنَ الْقُرُونِ قَوْمٍ كَفَرُوا حَلَّ بِهِمِ الْبَوَارِ. This is to scare us, to scare the people of Mecca. I have destroyed many centuries of people. مِنْ بَعْدِ نُوحٍ, after Sayyidina نوح عليه الصلاة والسلام. وكفى بربك بذنوب عباده أها خبيرا. Allah سبحانه وتعالى knows what we do and he sees what we do. We said here before that the destruction continued. سيدنا, and usually Allah سبحانه وتعالى give us these stories. Yeah? سيدنا نوح and سيدنا let's start a little bit by you know, chronically. Sayyidina Nuh, whenever he's talking about Sayyidina Nuh, he goes to Sayyidina Hud. After Hud, he goes to Salih, right? After Salih, sometimes he goes straight to Shu'aib. Sometimes he inserts Sayyidina Shu'aib, Sayyidina Ibrahim between Salih and usually said Allah said Nuh, Hud, Salih, and Shu'aib. After Shu'aib, he comes to Sayyidina, sometimes Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wa
السلام ايش يا
سيدنا نوح سيدنا هود بعد كل بي بتشين سيدنا نوح سيدنا هود لا اعرف وات لا اعرف سنشز الله سبحانه وتعالى نوح. قال وقرونا بين ذلك كثيرا قال وعادا وثمود نعم وقد قال في سورة الفرقان قال وقرونا بين ذلك وكلا ضربنا له الأمثال. So he sent us many people were destroyed. Why? لقلة المؤمنين. In those days when the messenger comes you have very very few people who what? Who believe in the message. قال فما آمن معه إلا فأهلكهم الله. نعم. And when the message people started becoming a Muslim in a great number, they started with Bani Israel. نعم. قال ولقد آتينا موسى الكتاب من بعد ما أهلكنا القرون الأولى بصائر. سيدنا موسى is not in this. You know, because Bani Israel massively at that particular time they became Muslim. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stopped the what? The destruction. Okay? قال ولقد أهلك. This ayah is very important. قال ولقد أهلكنا. ولقد آتينا موسى الكتاب من بعد ما أهلكنا القرون الأولى بصائر للناس. Okay, very very important. Now قال من كان يريد وكفى بربك بذنوب عباده خبيرا. Allah knows our sins and he knows what we are doing and he seizes them. Now he comes and tell us the whole thing about this dunya. من كان يريد العاجلة العاجلة بمعنى الدنيا. Whoever wants this dunya عجلنا له فيها ما نشاء لمن نريد. The scholar said, لمن نريد يعني لا يحصل من الدنيا إلا ما أريده أنا. I will give you dunya if you want dunya. But even that, أعطيك ما أريد. ثم جعلنا له جهنم. سبحان الله. And after that, جهنم is waiting for him. يصلاها مذموما مدحورا. This regarded, rejected. This human being, all he wants is what? Is dunya. Allah will give him. And this is where people have to think. We think sometimes that if people are rich, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love them. That's not the issue. He could give dunya to somebody whom he doesn't like at all. قال من كان يريد العاجلة عجلنا له فيها. والله many people say سبحان الله look at this. He has everything. But he's lucky. No, it doesn't have to be. He could have this. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is waiting for him. قال ثم جعلنا له جهنم يصلاها مذموما مدحورا ومن أراد الآخرة. If he wants الآخرة وسعى لها يعني عمل لها من الطاعات. Not only الآخرة. You have to work very hard for what? الآخرة. That is an issue. إن سلعة الله غالية. Some people will say, well, trust me, I'm a Muslim, but I'm not a practicing wife. Yeah, do you pray? No, I don't pray, but you know, my father, mashallah. I'm not a practicing Muslim, but you know, I'm from, yes, my name is Muhammad. Trust me. But it doesn't work for it. He thinks that you can be a Muslim without being a practicing wife. No, this face is different. قال تعالى وسعى لها سعيها حتى إذا أراد الآخرة ولم يسعى لها لن يحصلها. Even if you work for al-akhirah, you didn't work for it, you're not gonna get it. Not only that, قال وهو مؤمن. يعني there's an iman here, there's a belief here, an intention to do it, and working very hard to work. Ah, why did he say mu'min? Why? Because if there is no iman, Allah will not accept. There are so many people who think they are serving Allah and they want al-jannah, but they don't have what? There is no iman, which means they're not Muslims. Period. That's what we mean here by iman. Okay? وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا مِنْ ذَكَرٍ وَأُنْثَى وَهُوَ فَلَنُحْيِيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبَةً. Same thing here. And this ayah will show, people will say it doesn't matter if you're a good person, you are what? Yeah. Even the male Shirin bin Aqila Shaheed. Well, he was struggling. Yes, she's fine, but hey, Abu Aqla, is she a Muslim or Christian? Yeah. Let's be honest with ourselves. We even give a shahada today to people who are not Muslims. Yes. في الدنيا. نعم. نعم نعم. There's nothing wrong with that. This is how we said ربنا آتنا في الدنيا وفي الآخرة وقنا. The scholar said ليس هناك أجمع دعاء أكثر من هذا. There's no دعاء that's composed every good thing more than this one. And it's kind of دعاء الأنبياء. You don't want to be miserable here. To be, no, you want everything good for yourself here and what? But you put in your mind, what is what? What he means here, don't do anything here against Al-Akhirah. At the detriment, at the expense of what? Al-Akhirah. Usually this is what people do. I'm a scholar and I prefer to twist the truth, to lie, to support the government, even if it's doing something wrong, in order to maintain my place, and I'm destroying my own what? Al-Akhirah. Istahabu al-hayat al-dunya ala? This is what he means. It doesn't mean, ماذا قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم? What did he say? قال اعمل لدنياك كأنك تعيش أبدا وعمل لآخرتك كأنك تموت غدا. We want a good life here. وَهَذَا الدِّينَ هَذَا الدِّينَ إِنَّمَا بُعِثَ رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. You see, this is what it means. But what happened is that some people don't look, that only they look for is dunya. All they look for is what? Is dunya. At the expense of what? Al-akhirah. هذا الذي قاله الله عز وجل. من كان يريد العاجلة عجلنا له فيها. But أنت كمسلم يجب, you as a Muslim have to know that. Because what do? You see somebody very wealthy ولكنه كافر لا يصلي ولا, نقول ما شاء الله هذا الرجل, أي, this man is lucky, look, he has everything. لا 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 لا, ليس هذا هو الأمر. الله سبحانه وتعالى said if you work very hard for it, I will what? والله أنا have seen that in my life. You see somebody struggling, he doesn't pray, he doesn't fast, he was born a Muslim, he struggled to become even a president, Allah give it to him. This is what he worked for. But it's all about dunya. Jahannam is waiting for him. ثم جعلنا له جهنم يصلاها. ولكن من أراد الآخرة وسعى لها سعيها وهو مؤمن. He got this word, he inserted this word in it for you not to desire الآخرة when you are not Muslim. This will take everybody out of it. Who is not what? Who is not a mu'min? Who is not a Muslim? فَأُولَٰئِكَ كَانَ سَعْيُهُمْ مَشْكُورًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, الشكر هنا يعني مقبولا. قال وسعيك مشكور يعني مقبول. الله سبحانه وتعالى will accept those who strive for his sake. Okay, سبحان الله. قال كلا نمد هؤلاء أها وهؤلاء من عطاء ربك. Look this, look at this ayah. This Muslim, this kafir, Allah provide all of them, right? He provide for kafir too. The kafir has a car, he has a wife, he has children, he has a job, right? Sometimes he even has more than what. But you as a Muslim, Allah give you too. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give everything to kuffar, nobody is going to be Muslim. If you're only going to live here as, in misery, people will say that Islam is about misery. This is what is used to Zukhruf. قال ولولا أن تكون الناس أمة واحدة لجعلنا لمن أها لبيوتهم سقفا من فضة أها هو عارض عليها ولبيوتهم أبوابا إيه but sometimes he give to kafir and he give it to us too but you are the winner you see but قال كلا نمد هؤلاء و بعطاء ربك وما كان عطاء ربك محذورا سبحان الله and Allah سبحانه وتعالى his gift is for al-kafir Allah created al-kafir and to feed him is responsible about that قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم في أحاديثه قال إن الله يعطي الدنيا لمن يحب ومن لا يحب ولا يعطي الآخرة إلا لمن يحب Okay, قال كلا نمد هؤلاء وهؤلاء من عطاء ربك وما كان عطاء ربك أها انظر every single question one of the miracle of القرآن الكريم when you ask me a question maybe the next ayah will answer that what question والله قال انظر كيف فضلنا بعضهم على بعض even is this dunya Allah prefers us to each other. There's somebody who's in the middle, okay? There's somebody who's very poor, there's somebody who's very who's rich, and someone else who's filthy rich. Okay, Abdullah, fadda. Look at this. قال كلا نمد هؤلاء and this is going to be the last of this evening inshallah. May Allah give us the reward of tafsir. كلا نمد هؤلاء وهؤلاء من عطائي. I will give this Muslim and I will just give what? الكافر. وما كان عطاء ربك محذورا. سبحان الله. محبوسا ممنوعا. قال انظر كيف فضلنا بعضهم على بعض and we said here before why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't create us equal right if we were equal in everything what would have happened the life will stop why am I driving a bus to take you I have $1 million I will sit home, right? But who are you going to call to drive? He has $1 million too. Huh? Why am I going to go for farming and suffer in the rain and to bring you food? No. I need food myself. I have money. Everybody is rich, nothing will happen. Nobody is moved to do what? Anything. وذلك قال ليتخذ بعضكم بعضا سخرية يعني يسخر بعضنا البعض. If we don't do that, life will totally stop. وهذه من حكمة الله. أن فضل بعض الناس على بعض لكي يسخر البعض البعض. I will use you and you will use me too. You see? Yes. Everybody has to do something in order for the life to continue. وما كان عطاء ربك محذورا يعني ممنوعا. Allah will never prevent anyone from his from what he gives. This is why you will find a kafir. He has food, he has everything. But a Muslim also has it. قال انظروا كيف فضلنا بعضهم على بعض. I preferred one of them to the other. قال وللآخرة أكبر درجات. But you have to know that we even have more degrees. We prefer people to each other in الآخرة more. الكافر والمسلم هذا equal in الآخرة. لا. Even al-Jannah, we are not equal in Jannah. Al-Jannah darajatun, wal-Naru darakatun. Even Jannah. وَهَذَا مِنْ عَدِّ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. That is a gift. Even in Jahannam, they said the nice, good people, they are somewhere, their punishment is less severe than those who are in the bottom. That's why I said, إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ فِي الدَّرْكِ الْأَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ. You'll find some kafir here is very nice, very kind, he has charity, doesn't get to Al-Jannah, but his punishment is what? It's less. العياذ بالله. الدرجة يرتفع والدرك ينزل. درجات هي مترادفة. الدرجات والدركات. وذا قال في الدرك الأسفل من النار. أوكي؟ قال أها قال وللآخرة أكبر أها درجات وأكبر تفضيلا. سبحان الله. لا تجعل مع الله إلها آخر فتقعد ملوما أها مذموما إيه مخزولا. سبحان الله. And we will stop there إن شاء الله. Do not associate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فتقعد أي تبقى. Then you become مذموما مخزولا. You will sit in a disgrace and destitution. Okay? Humiliated. Because association to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a major sin. And after that, we get to وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَنْ لَا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّهُ which has a lot of ahkam, and the time is almost here. Inshallah, I will stop here till next. I will be skipping next week. I will be traveling for 10 days. And inshallah, a week after, I will be here. Barakallahu feekum. I may. I'm traveling. Make dua for us, inshallah. Just for 10 days. And it just happened, Sheikh will take my spot. Yeah. Sheikh will talk about something else, inshallah. So I can keep my... I'm going just for a few days. Not for a month, no. Maybe by January 10, 15, I'll be here, inshallah. Okay, I'm going to Morocco. Barakallahu. السلام عليكم. No, I will be leaving.